episode 2850, Love for a Lifetime.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive by. Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for a fabulous weekend. I'm ready for some time off. It has been a crazy, awesome, productive week, but I need a breather. I need some football time. I need some husband time. I just need some God time. Have you ever felt like that? Well, today it's relationship builders. And you know what? I mentioned about the hubby time. Yep, love for a lifetime. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Marriages last not because they were destined to last. Marriages last long because two people made a choice to work for it, to fight for it, and to keep it. Love for a lifetime. Are you holding your spouse to a higher standard? Oh, come on, be honest, please. I do, all the time. And I hold myself to a higher standard. And I hold my children. And I hold, well, basically, I hold the world to a higher standard. But do you think they can live up to that higher standard? Nope, because most of the time they don't know our higher standard. We haven't defined it for them. And if you have not defined your standard for your husband, for your wife, you know what? They're gonna always fail you, always. Love for a lifetime is worth millions of tries. Let me ask you this interesting question. And I know you have not even thought about this one. Would you bet on your marriage or the Powerball? Oh, yeah, gotcha. Why? Because, okay, you still have time. It is November 5th, and they're going to draw the Powerball. It's at a record high, $1.5 billion estimated. And I am not at all saying to go get a Powerball. No, I'm not saying that. That is your choice. You get to decide. I'm not here giving you any financial advice. However, I do think we're willing to gamble on Powerballs, but we're not willing to bet on a marriage, and we take vows. We made a commitment. And I know as a Christian, as a believer, that wasn't just between two, you know, earthly beings. That was a covenant between myself, my husband, and God. That's pretty powerful. But what's crazy more powerful is that we would still go spend money on a Powerball. What if you were to buy $10 worth of Powerball tickets every single week? There's 52 weeks in a year, so it's $520. What if you took that $520, made it equal to however much time, you know, give it a quantity of time to it? So, you know, to earn that much money, it would take you this much time. What if you spent that time and invested that into your marriage? Game changer, even if it's only 2 or 3 hours. Because I'm here to tell you, we are living by habits, circumstances, and truly, we're just going through the motions. We're not in it to win anything. We don't want to have to fight because we're tired of fighting. We just think, oh, I should come home and my husband should be here. I should come home and my wife should be waiting. Really? Have you given him a reason to love you? And I know that's, I'm going to get some emails on that, but I got to push back a little bit. It takes two to tango. Both you and your spouse have to show up. Because the picture that's been painted years and years and years and years, decades ago, right, is that we can have this fairy tale life. White house, white picket fence, you know, you meet your Prince Charming. But if you don't have your Prince Charming, or you do, but he does you wrong, then maybe it's time to move on. Is that kind of how you handle things? You don't want conflict, so it's easy just to run and hide. It's easy to slam the door in your spouse's face. You see, love for a lifetime, well, it takes commitment, sacrifice, and grace. Think about it. If love was easy, everyone would be in love. But it's not. We see breakups all the time. Have you ever watched The Bachelor? And if you haven't watched, or The Bachelorette, or if you haven't watched a whole thing, have you even seen a commercial? Oh, yes. I think all of us have seen the commercials. ABC wants to make sure we all see the commercials. And if you ever watch Bachelor in Paradise, it's 1,000,000,000 times percent worse. There's breakups all the time. Breakups now are normal. And so when someone says, I'm getting divorced, we just don't really have a response because that's the new normal. Would you like to break that mold? Do you want a different marriage? Love for a lifetime. You know, I find it very interesting that when we are pushed up against a brick wall, it's easier to walk away. It's easier to duck, run away. But it doesn't help our family structure when society makes it easy to break the ties and get a divorce. And it's so easy now. And if you don't want to argue over things and you're very okay with just, okay, this is how we're dividing it, you both agree, man, you can just literally take your credit card and you get a divorce. It's not that complicated. And now with technology, shoot, it's probably a lot easier. But you got to remember, love for a lifetime requires sacrifice, grace, and commitment. So are you ready for the fight? That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Ready for the fight. You got to get ready for the battle all the time. You can't rely on your habits. You definitely cannot rely on your circumstances because life will fail you because life happens. So you've got to dig deeper and want greater. If you desire that love for a lifetime, there is a fight to be won, but it's not one with your spouse, but one with yourself. Sometimes we're fighting the wrong person. Look in the mirror. And I say that honestly. It starts with ourselves. And it's so hard to get that because we all go to pointing the fingers. And I get that. I went through craziness. But you know what? I had to own my own junk. He had to own his, but I had to own mine first in order for us to come together. Now, he had to own his stuff too, but that wasn't my responsibility. I can only control what I can control. So ready for the fight. What does that look like in real life? Number one, forgiveness. One of the hardest things in the world to do, forgiveness. Life is not perfect, so you have to be willing to push through the failures, the hurts and disagreements, and forgive that which does not meet your expectations. Love hurts, but love wins too. I mean, I can only go to how God sent his son. We are hitting and coming into the holidays. And I think of Jesus Christ and born as a babe, walk this earth to become one like us. So he understands us, like physically, emotionally, spiritually. He knows what it feels like to love, to be hurt. And he had to learn to accept hurt, but in return, give love. Are you showing that to your spouse? Forgiveness. But remember, you have to show it to yourself first, right? That reflection. If you could do it with yourself, it's easier to do to somebody else. But man, it's so hard for ourselves. Number two, sacrifice. You have to be willing to sometimes give up what you want. Not all the time, but sometimes. It's putting your personal preferences aside to serve the greater good of the relationship. Some would call it compromise. I call it sacrifice. Because when you don't get what you want, You don't like it. Come on. That's the humanness in us, right? If we don't get what we want, man, we're not real happy. I don't care what it is. I don't care if it's your fast food cheeseburger or if it's $1 million, right? You want those Powerball numbers. Doesn't everybody else in the world? But you see, we don't always get what we want. So we have to be willing to put our personal preferences aside for the greater good of the relationship called love, called commitment, forgiveness, sacrifice. Number three, grace. As much as you give grace, you too need to be willing to receive grace. It goes both ways. And believe it or not, I find it interesting on this one. A lot of people will give people that, I get it. You're busy. You weren't meaning anything. But then when it's an extension to them, meaning you, me, we're like, oh, and we just apologize up and down and all around. We keep bringing it up. Do you think men like to hear the stories over and over and over and over again that we women like to tell over and over and over and over again? No. So if we cannot receive the grace, but we can give it, oh, that can be a detriment to our marriage. We've got to not only be able to give it away, but we need to receive it. Most of the time, that's hard for us to do. We're fine with giving it, but receiving it, what does that also mean? Oh, that means I'm guilty. I'm not perfect. Something's messed up with me, right? Yeah, we got to own some other stuff. Hence, forgiveness, sacrifice, grace. And finally, number four, a tough one, commitment. When the going gets tough, are you holding on? Are you willing to throw in the towel? Are you willing to say, nope, 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 that's it? I don't want to work that hard. Nothing in life that comes easy is worth having. What you really want is what you work for. Love matters. Your marriage matters. Your relationships deepening, that matters. This is what wraps around love. So what in your reflection do you say, wow, I'm just, on my grading scale, I'm just not doing too well here. I don't want you to say all of them, because you probably do a lot of good in all of them, but you can do better in one of them. And that's the one I want you to look at. That's the one I want you to focus on. Maybe it is that grace. Maybe you've got commitment down, but the commitment is done with, well, parameters and expectations. Are you willing to let go of that and say, I love you unconditionally? Wait, I love me unconditionally. Now, that doesn't mean you go and you get to do whatever you want to do and everything's okay and you don't have to answer to anybody. I'm not saying that at all. There are healthy boundaries in a marriage that two adult individuals come together and they decide on what their marriage looks like. I would encourage following biblical standards. That's what we do in our marriage. Are we perfect? No. Do we try? Yes. And when we continually make that investment into our marriage, what do you think happens? Our foundation just keeps stronger and stronger and it gets deeper and deeper. So when a tornado comes, that hurricane hits, you can withstand any storm. Love for a lifetime is for you to have and to hold from this day forward. But remember, you get to decide what that love looks like. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.